the whole tune-up and checking the gas lines to make sure they're not blocked. And of course, don't forget to put your spark plug wire back on. All right, there we go. All right, everybody. It's Rob again with a do-it-yourself, another do-it-yourself video. This is the same blower that I recently replaced the ignition module on because the unit kept shutting down on me. So I have that video up on YouTube if you want to check that out. But now I'm going to do a simple tune-up on this. I'm going to replace the air filter. This is a kit I bought over at the store. So that's the air filter, the spark plug, and the fuel filter. The one thing that this kit doesn't include, which I wish it did, is the gas vent. There's a vent under here. Now, I'm going to check that vent out later after I get done doing the rest of the tune-up here. So, just to make sure that that's okay. I mean, the unit is running fine ever since I replaced the module. So if you have an Echo blower that's shutting down unexpectedly while you're using it, you can check that video out on how to replace that ignition module, and that should help you get your blower running again and not shutting off on you. So anyway, again, this is a simple tune-up. I'm going to take that spark plug out first. All right, this will be the spark plug on that is three quarter inch spark plug socket should do it. Pretty easy, just a simple thing. I don't believe you have to gap the spark plugs on these. I think they come pre-gapped. So there's the old plug. I mean, to me, it doesn't look too bad. It actually looks pretty clean. But I'm going to replace it anyway, since I already got the kit. And might as well take this off, too, because we're going to replace the air filter, too. Very simple. Just a wing nut that holds the thing on. It's not too bad, but I don't think it's blocked or anything. Just make sure the area is clean. Get the debris out of there. Just make sure none of it falls in here and then end up getting sucked into the engine. You don't want that to happen. So that's pretty much clean. Now, later on, I am going to, as I said, I'm going to replace the fuel filter, which is inside the tank. So you got to fish the line out of the tank to replace that. Now, down here, let me see if I can give you a better, more well-lit view of it. So, right here behind the gas cap is where all of your lines go in. So your feed line for the gas to the carburetor, and your vent line that comes out, and your vent is right here. That's your vent. Now these vents, I don't believe I ever had one block on any of my equipment, but they say if they do block, it can choke your engine off and it will shut down. Now, when you're gonna take, I'm gonna eventually take all three of these lines right out. There's a grommet there. I'm going to pull them all out and make sure that all those lines are clear right through, because I've heard also stories of those lines blocking solid. which will also make your equipment shut down unexpectedly or run poorly because it's starving for fuel. But make sure, I don't have any right now, but make sure you get a can of brake parts cleaner and spray that area, because it gets all gunked up like you see here, and you don't want any of that falling in your gas tank. So I'm not going to do that part until I do get the can of brake parts cleaner. But I'm going to replace the air filter and the spark plug right now. And I'm probably going to wait on the gas filter until I get that can of brake parts cleaner so I can finish that. So I can show you a complete tune-up. And I'll show you also how to make sure this piece is not blocked solid, because again, that will choke off your engine. So let's open this up. I'll have to get a knife here because this plastic is pretty heavy duty. Again, if you find my videos useful, my YouTube channel is not just about trains. You know, just do-it-yourself videos up there. Just a few videos, and if you find them useful, give them a thumbs up. It helps the channel, and it'll help other people to be able to view that same video, because it'll give it a more positive algorithm, and more people will be able to view that or find it. Packaging is ridiculous on this. Alright, so there's your new spark plug right there. Let me see if I can eye that. Yeah, that doesn't need to be gapped. That's okay. So we'll just twist that in there. And snug it up. You don't have to go crazy on it. Now, it looks like I'm going a little bit crazy on it, doesn't it? But I'm really not. There's a washer that when you start tightening it, the washer has to flatten. So it's like kind of like a sandwich style washer where it flattens down. So it makes a better seal around the cylinder opening, around the opening for the spark plug for the cylinder. All right, that should be good. Oh my God, the packaging on these, it's just overkill. All right, so there's the air filter. Just pop that in there. Very simple. Very simple, very easy. And that's it. That's it for that. Okay. So, and as I said, I'm going to go to the auto parts store, and I'm going to get a can of brake parts cleaner before I tackle the rest of this and change the fuel filter. So you'll be able to see the... Alright, so what we're going to do next is we're going to change the fuel filter on this Echo blower. And again, it's the Echo PB250LN. Alright, so first, what you want to do is, after a couple years of use, you'll see a lot of dirt built up in there and grease around the area where the fuel filter, the lines go in, right in here. So you can clearly see all the grease and grime built up. So you're definitely going to want to get all that away. Use brake parts cleaner to clean all that off. And some people, I think, just pry the rubber grommet up that's in the tank right in there. But this gives you very little room to work with. So I'm going to take this tank completely off. Now over here, you have two Allen key style screws. One here, to remove this bracket. And once you pull that bracket out, you can pull the whole tank out and unhook your gas lines, the air line, the vent line, stuff like that. You can unhook all that in the return line, and you can pull this whole tank out and then pry the rubber grommet up out of the tank, because obviously the fuel filter is down in there. So that's the way I'm going to do it. You know, you can do it. You know, you can take a shortcut method if you want and try to pry it up from here, unhook all the lines from the carburetor up here if you want to. But I'm not going to do it that way. I'm going to do it the right way. I'm going to pull this tank completely out. And again, spray brake parts cleaner in here. Get all this grime out of here before you start to remove the lines in the tank. So you don't want anything, you know, getting stuck in the tank, any kind of dirt like that. So that's what I'm going to do. I have these bolts loosened up. I'm not going to show you how to loosen these bolts up. You know how to do that. You know, that's self-explanatory if you know what you're doing anyway. You know your way around tools and everything. So you know what you're doing. The lines here, the fuel line feed, the return, the vent. Of course, the vent only attaches to the vent. That's that piece right there. That's the vent. You don't have to take that off unless you're changing that anyway. So, but the return line and the feed line, obviously you got to pull them down off the carburetor. They push on. So that's what we're going to do next. And once I get that tank off, I'll show you the additional steps here. All right, so I have the tank all cleaned up, as you can see. I use brake parts cleaner to clean the tank up, all the gunk around here. So the two lines you're going to take off are in here, behind this guard, the black line and the clear line. These are the only two lines you have to unhook from the carburetor. Now just note the way that you take them off. The black line facing it goes on the right, and the clear line goes on the left. So just note that as you're taking them off. And once you take these off and you have this plate removed here, you can pull this tank right out and then proceed to pry up the grommet in here that holds all the fuel lines, and you'll pull the gas filter right up out of the unit. But again, you know, make sure that you use brake parts cleaner to clean this whole area off, because it gets really, really gunked up over the years that you're using this, and you don't want anything to fall in the tank or fall inside the line itself and end up causing a problem inside the carburetor by blocking it up. So that's your next step. Remove the bracket all the way. I have it loosened up. I don't know what size the Allen key was, because my Allen key here that I have does not have a size on it. It's a cheapy Craftsman one. Craftsman makes better ones too, but this one did not have a size on it anywhere. So I'm not quite sure what size it is, but in your Allen key set, you'll figure it out. You could try every one until it fits the screw, and then pull them out of there, and the fuel line out as well. All right, so I made a mistake here when I was taking out this outer bracket that holds the tank in. That would be this bracket here that holds the tank in. These are actually T25 Torx. screws. I used an Allen key to remove the outer screws, which it will work. I just don't know what size it was because, like I said, it doesn't say on the Allen key itself. But a little bit further in, back in here, you have two more screws that hold the tank in as well, besides that outer bracket. And they are T25 Torx, obviously, bits. So T25s will remove those. So that's the size for them and for the outer bracket as well. But an Allen key will work. You know, again, I don't know what size that was, but it will work. Sorry about the hissing in the background. That's actually my furnace working double time as it's 8 degrees here right now in Wilkes-Barre Township. So again, two inner bolts, screws actually, that will allow you to take this tank completely out. All right, so when you're removing the fuel lines from the carburetor, this one and this one, both, just to be on the safe side, use a flathead screwdriver and pry it away a little bit to break the seal on it so you can pull it off without actually breaking that line. Same with this one. And you might want to remove these fuel lines when the unit is sitting upright. Otherwise, you'll get, if you have gas in here already, like I do, I mean, ideally, I probably should have emptied this gas out, a little bit in there, but I didn't. So, my bad, whatever. But, you know, remove them when the unit is sitting upright. And you'll get a little bit of gas that's going to come out. So, put something down to absorb it and just pull these lines off. And once you have the lines off, you can take the tank right out. All right, so once you have the both gas lines free, the black one on the right, looking straight at it, and the clear one on the left, again, looking straight at the primer bulb, you can pull the tank right out like that. Very easy. Here's your vent. Now, if your kit came with the vent, replace it. And you'll see a little clip around it. You can replace that clip. The vent itself. And go from there. But right now, I mean, I've already replaced this vent. So I'm going to be replacing the fuel filter itself inside the tank. My tank is still a little bit dirty back in here, but I cleaned it where it counts. And while I have it off, I'm going to clean the rest of it out. Off and, you know, get it nice and shiny new again. So that's our next step, to replace that fuel filter. Now, if you want, I could have mentioned this step earlier, but I like to be a little bit more thorough when I'm doing work on my equipment. So, what you could do, instead of taking this grommet out, now, of course, you would take the grommet out for sure if it was failing. If this grommet was deteriorated and popping out anyway, obviously, you would have to replace that. But what you could do, this is the fuel filter. Of course, it attaches right there. What you could do is you could avoid some of the steps that I gave you, and you could use an Allen key like this, and you can fish down into the tank and grab onto the line and pull the whole unit up outside the tank this way through the gas floor neck and get your fuel filter out that way. You could do that, you know, that's perfectly fine. But you know, if you want to check for block lines, you know, take the additional steps. And if you want to clean your your equipment up a little bit more, you can do it that way as well. You can take the whole thing apart. So you could do it that way. It's not the wrong way, you know. But I just choose to do it a more thorough way, I guess you would say, you know. But I'm sure I'm gonna get some comments on this video and, oh, why'd you do it that way? Eh, whatever. But I do it the way I do it because I'm just a little bit more thorough. Now, there's a metal ring here, right here on the hose. So you would push the fuel filter back on, like that. Then you would just push the ring back over this whole thing. Sometimes the ring's a little hard to get on. Just be careful with it because you don't want to kink the hose. Or, not kink the hose, but you don't want to put a crack in the hose. Sometimes it is a little hard to get on there. You just gotta kind of manipulate it on. Like that. So start with the tension ring at the end of the hose, like that, and push it on there, and the tension ring will spread and go on like that. So there's your fuel filter. Again, you can take the shortcut and do it the easy way and push the Allen key down into the hole and do it that way if you want. You know, it's up to you. So there it is. Fuel filter is in there. Brand new fuel filter. There's your old one. But I like to do things in a more thorough way and just clean it all up the best I can and make it look shiny new again. Then you're ready for another couple of years of use, right? So look at that, brand new again. And there we are. Tank looks as good as new. Again, you could choose to do it. You could take the shortcut if you'd like. Either way, it works. It works. But if you want to clean it up nice, do it the way I showed you. Take the grommet out. Especially if the grommet, again, if this grommet is all deteriorated and it's popping up out as you're using the equipment and you find yourself pushing that back down in, because you have gas leaking all over the place. Obviously, you need to replace that, because over time, gas will deteriorate that rubber. I've had that happen on my previous blower before I replaced it with this one. I've had that happen before. So, there you go. Tank is all ready to go. You did your tune-up, your spark plug, your air filter, and you're ready to put that back together. So grab your blower, and at this point, your lines, you know, I told you where your lines go. They should be lined up. Right side, looking at the primer bulb. Left side, looking at the primer bulb. Clear, black. And your vent tube it just hangs inside there. You know, it doesn't go in any specific spot, so. So I'll just put your tank back in. Like that. Those lines back onto the carburetor. Make sure you push them all the way on. And, you know, when it comes to the screws that go back in here, the inner screws, the ones that are inside on the top, right on the top, not the ones that are on the bracket that come out here, but the ones that are inside, those are the ones that have the washer. They have the washer on them. The outer ones do not have the washer. So just remember that. The inner ones towards the engine have the washer. And once summer hits, when spring hits actually, this blower will be ready to go for another year. where it seems like sometimes the simplest things are the hardest things. All right, so I'm having some trouble getting this screw in. Whatever, right? Sometimes the screws are a little bit hard to line up, I guess, but whatever. It's not that bad. Again, if you choose to do it the easy way by pulling up the difficult time lining them up. Alright, so again, just make sure you line those screws up properly so you don't cross-thread them. Seems like it's easy to cross-thread them. Okay, that's alright though. Just back it off a little bit, you'll get it. There's your bracket. Again, you could take the easy road and just not do what I did. I just go the extra mile and clean things up a bit. That's what I do. And I figured it's the off season anyway. I'm not using the blower for anything, and it's not imperative to get it back on the road. Or back in the yard, as you would say. Too quickly. So again, you can fish the fuel filter up out of the tank. Using a piece of wire, a piece of coat hanger. You could use the on key that I showed you. And you could do it that way. I just choose to do it the other way because it allows me to inspect the gas lines and the grommet. You know what I mean? It allows you to inspect everything that's in here. The hooks of the carp, so you can tell, if it's worthy or not, whether or not you have to replace that. So anyway, there you go. That's your complete tune-up of an Echo blower. The model is PB250LN, and that's it. That's all you got to do. I didn't replace the primer bulb because the primer bulb is pretty good on this yet. So we replaced the plug, the air filter, the gas filter. We checked all the lines to make sure they're good. And if you really want to go the extra step, if after replacing the ignition module and your unit is still shutting down on you, just make sure you take these gas lines completely out. And make sure that they're not clogged through. And if worse comes to worse, it would be your carburetor that's all gunked up. So just make sure to look at that as well if you're still having issues with the unit shutting down unexpectedly, or especially if it's running poorly. So anyway, that's it. And thanks for watching. And I hope you get something from this video. If you do, please give me a thumbs up and a like. Give me a comment, negative, positive. Doesn't matter. Thanks for watching. This is Rail Fan Rob, over and out.